So after the colonization of the Spaniards, the Americans, and the Japanese, here comes the contemporary period whereas we achieve our liberation, or we are being freed from the colonizer of our country. So what we're going to talk about today is all about the Philippine literature under the contemporary period or the modern period. So that happens right after the Filipino won over the battle between the Japanese with the help of the Americans. So what we're going to talk about here is the rebirth of freedom. So it happens right after the colonization of the Japanese in 1945. And it happens when the American returned in 1945. Filipinos rejoice, and guerrillas who fled to the mountain joined the liberating American army. So there is a connection between the Americans and some of the guerrillas, or these are the Filipino people who fought against the Japanese government. And on July 4, or the 4th of July, 1946, which happens also to be the Liberation Day of the United States of America, the Philippines regained its freedom, and the Filipino flag waved joyously alone. The chains were already broken. So it means we are no longer under the government of the Americans. So we are really liberated and freed from their governance in our country. Let's talk about the state of literature during that period. So since, if you're going to look at the history, nung tinignan natin yung, or pinag-aralan natin yung about the literature during the Japanese period, di ba pinagbawal nila ang paggamit ng wikang Ingles? And although nabigyan ng pagkakataon ng mga Filipino writer to start another set of years to establish literary pieces, dito, mas lalo tayong nabigyan ng kalayaan in terms of expressing our thoughts and expressing what is, or what are those things that is on our mind. The early post-liberation period was marked by a kind of struggle of mind and spirit, posed by the sudden emancipation from the enemy and the wild desire to see print. And now, if we're going to look back at the past, we are being prohibited in terms of printing our works. But now, when we achieve that particular age, or the post-liberation age, we are now expecting that the government, or the people who manage or who governs our country, will probably let our works to be printed. And here are some of the literary pieces who were printed after that particular period under the Japanese government. So the first one is The Heart of Islands. It was written on 1947, 2 years after we became freed from the Japanese. It's a collection of poems written by Manuel Viray. The second one is Philippines Cross Section. It was printed on 1950. Here it is a collection of prose and poetry, and it was collected and compiled by Maximo Ramos and Florentino Valeros. And then the next one, the third one, is the Prose and Poems. It was written or collected on 1952 by Nick Joaquin. And number four, we have The Philippine Writing in 1953 by T.D. Agkawili. Next is The Philippine Harvest by Amador Dagayo, or Dagyo. And number six, The Horizon's Least 1967. It's a collection of works by professors of UB, or the University of the East, mostly in English, short stories, essays, research papers, poem, and drama. And it was collected or being compiled by Artemio Patatsin and Silverio Baltazar. If we're going to go back to that particular time, the themes of the most poems deal with the usual love of nature and social and political problems. Toribio Amandi's poems showed deep emotional intensity at that particular theme. And number seven, who spoke of courage in his sleep by N.V.M. Gonzalez. And number eight, Speak Not, Speak Also by Conrado Pedroche. And other poets were Toribio Amandi and Edith Tiempo. Jose Garcia Villas have come and here won acclaim both here and abroad. So, the Filipino writers totally emerged or bigla na lang silang naglabasan right after our liberalism from Japanese government. So here comes the new Filipino literature during this period. So the Philippine literature in Tagalog was revived during this period. Most themes and writings dealt with Japanese brutalities. So medyo may kinalaman naman ngayon, aside from the love of nature, love of the country, most of the Filipino writers focus on the things that have that these Japanese people have done to us, to our country, the brutalities, comfort women, and other things that cause them not to look good in our eyes, and of poverty of life under the Japanese government and the brave guerrilla exploits. So again, it's these brave guerrilla shows love for the country. That is why it is it became one of the subject for the Philippine literature during the contemporary period. Let's move on to the next. And during the 1970 and 1972, it was called as the period of activism. Why? Because many young people became activists to ask for changes in the government. And the expression of this desire for change, keen were the writings of some youth who were fired with nationalism in order to emphasize the importance of their petitions. So, nung panahon na yon, right after we became freed from doing what we want to do, or when we achieve our liberalization time, that's the time also that these people or young people wants to express their thoughts on their minds, probably out of curiosity and for all the things that they are feeling right now. They still don't feel that they are free because they are very, very limited. So many young people became activists because they wanted to have change in our government, since we are still following the ways that these colonizers taught us. Like for example, the government. The changes in education, like for example, when the Americans introduces the public school, and right after that, the Japanese limits the use of English language, whereas it was being taught to us by the Americans. It has certain changes that could probably make these young people thought that our government is not on a good state. So that emerged the period of activism from 1970 to 1972, and it lasts almost 2 years. But until now, we're going to look at the present time, or go back to the present time, or move to the present times. You can see people are really now achieving their freedom of expression. Rally, exploitations, things that are really against to the will of our government is being is happening all throughout the country. Next is the literary revolution. What do you think would be this all about? So, if you're going to look back at the history again, on 1970 to 1972, there comes the period of activism, and it happens that people on that particular period is really very in a state of urge or in a state of parang palaban, parang gustong gawin ang lahat ng gusto nilang gawin. Then the youth became completely rebellious during this period. This was proven not only in the bloody demonstrations and in the sidewalk expression, but also in literature. So the most common things that we could read from that particular period is more on brutality and other negative things about our government. Campus newspapers shows rebellious emotions. The once aristocratic writers developed awareness for society. They held pens and wrote on placards in red paint, the equivalent of the word makibaka, to dare. So when we talk about the word makibaka, it means they are encouraging other people to do also the same thing that they are doing, a negative thing that they are doing. Writings during the period of activism. The irreverence for the poor reached its peak during this period of the mass revolution. It was also during this period that Bomba films that discredit our race as Filipinos started to come out. So pag sinabi nating Bomba films, these are films which expresses too much liberation, naked people doing sex for film and a lot of things that is truly negative for the perception of others. And still, there will still be a positive things that are happening during that time. So here comes the Palangka Award. Palangka Award is for literature in English. It was established in 1950. The Palangka Memorial Awards for Literature have been giving cash prizes for short story, poetry, and one-act play, writing as an incentive to Filipino writers. The prizes come from Latondena Incorporated, the firm founded by the late Carlos Palangka Sr. So it was named after Carlos Palangka Sr. That is why they are giving this award for playwrights or writers, authors of a short story, poetry, one act play, and many more. Then here comes the period of the new society. So during the period of activism, here comes also the period of the new society. It means people are trying to change the way they feel during the government of under the government of Japanese. So the period of new society started on September 21, 1972. The Carlos Palangka Awards continue to give annual awards. Almost all themes in most writings deal with the development or progress of the country. So, from being destroyed during the colonization period of these countries like Spain, America, and Japan, up to the part where we already achieved our liberalization or yung pagiging malaya natin. So like Green Revolution when we talk about Green Revolution, it's a revolution that talks about the nature, family planning, proper nutrition, environment, drug addiction, and pollution.
The new society tried to stop pornography, which happens when the bomba films emerge, or those writings giving bad influences on the morals of the people. All school newspapers were temporarily stopped, and so with school organizations. And Filipino poetry during the period of the new society. Kung titignan natin, medyo magiging iba ang naging tema ng mga sulatin or mga literary piece na nagawa ng mga writers under the period of the new society. So themes of the most poems dealt with patience, regard for native culture, customs, and the beauties of nature and surroundings. So the period of new society provides us the chance or the opportunity to see the beauty still of our country, even though it was being used or abused by some of the colonizers of our country. And of course, the people itself living in this country. Then, let's talk about the play under the new society. The government led in reviving old plays and dramas like the Tagalog Zarzuela, Senaculo, and Embayoka of the Muslims, which were presented in the rebuilt of Metropolitan Theater, the Folk Arts Theater, and the Cultural Center of the Philippines. So probably this is under the presidency of Ferdinand Marcos. So we have our Zarzuela, Senaculo, and Embayoka of the Muslims, which are being played in Spanish, most specifically the Zarzuela and Senaculo. Senaculo is showing the Passion of the Christ from the moment he was being captured by these soldiers and bring to and let him carry the cross going pass through the Via Dolorosa road in Israel up to the mountain where he was being crucified to death. So here comes also the Metropolitan Theater, where the Metro Manila Film Festival originated. And of course, the Cultural Center of the Philippines, which can be found in Pasay City. Radio and television. So radio continued to be patronized during this period. The plays here is like Simatar, Dalia, Ito ang Palad Ko, and Mr. Lonely were the forms of recreation of those without television. And early Filipino films, a yearly pistan ng mga pelikulang Pilipino, yearly Filipino Film Festival. So ito yung sinasabi ko kanina na in modern times, ito ay tinatawag ng Metro Manila Film Festival. And during the festival, which lasted usually for a month, only Filipino films were shown in all theaters in Metro Manila. So, number one, Maynila, Sa Mga Kuko ng Liwanag, which was written by Edgardo Reyes and filmed under the direction of Lino Broca. Bembol Rocco was the lead role of this film. Another one is Minsay Isang Gamugamo. It was being presented to us by Nora Honor, and she was considered was the principal performer of this film. Next, Ganito Kami Noon, Paano Kayo Ngayon, which was led by the very good actor Christopher De Leon and Gloria Diaz. Another film emerged during that time is The Insyang, which was presented to us by Hilda Coronel. Aguila, led by Fernando Poe Jr., Jay Ilagan, and Christopher De Leon. And aside from that, although films and other forms of literature are emerging, here comes the written one, comics, magazines, and other publications. So during this period of the new society, newspapers donned new forms. And news and economic progress, discipline, culture, tourism, and the like were favored more than the sensationalized reporting of killings, rape, and robberies. Let's talk about now the overview of the literature during the new society. So bilingual education, which was initiated by the Board of National Education as early as 1958, and continued up to the period of martial rule in September 21st, 1972, resulted in the deterioration of English in the different levels of education. The focus of education and culture was on problems of national identity and on reorientation, renewed vigor, and affirmed resolves to carry out plans and programs. So bilingual education also emerged. When we talk about bilingual education, it means you will be using two set of languages in terms of giving instruction, in terms of teaching the students, and vice versa, for the students to learn not only one language but also the other language came from other countries. And the next one, let's talk about the period of the Third Republic. It happens during 1981 and to 1985. After 10 years of military rule and some changes in the life of the Filipino, which started under the new society, martial rule was at last lifted on January 2nd, 1981. And here comes again the Filipino poetry. Poems during this period of the Third Republic were romantic and revolutionary. Romantic in a sense of, it talks about couples, it talks about relationship between man and women. And of course, it also has the theme of revolutionary, since we are not under a freed government, under the martial rule made by our past president, Ferdinand Marcos. So the supplications of the people were couched in fiery, colorful, violent, profane, and insulting language. Filipino songs. Many Filipino songs dealt with themes that were really true to life, like those of grief, poverty, aspirations for freedom, love of God, of country, and of fellow men. So one of the famous songs that I have, that I could still remember, which was, I think, made at this time, is what we call the Tagumpay Nating Lahat, which has the lyrics like, sama-sama nating abutin, pinaka matayog na bituin. At ang ating tagumpay, tagumpay ng ating lahi, tagumpay ng ating lipi. At ang tanging minimithi at hinahangad, hangad ko ay tagumpay nating lahat. And that is one of the songs which really gives me an idea about the love of country and to the fellow man. And another Philippine film's concept during the period. The yearly festival of Filipino films continued to be held during this period, and people's love for sex films also was unabated. During the 1986 to 1999, history took another twist. Once more, the Filipino people regained their independence, which they lost 20 years ago. In the span of 4 days, from February 21st to 25th, 1986, the so-called People Power or Lakas ng Bayan prevailed. Together, the people barricaded the streets, petitioning the government for changes and reforms. On newspapers and other publications, newspapers which were once branded crony newspapers became instant opposition papers overnight. So it means yung mga dyaryo noon na dati ay hindi lang siya source ng mga balita para sa mga current events, it also happens to be the side of the people who are opposing the government. So most of the content of these newspapers are more on against the government. This was true of Bulletin Today, which became the opposition paper. And speaking about books, the Philippine Revolution of 1986 and the Fire of its Spirit, that will carry the Filipinos through another epoch in Philippine history, is still being documented just as they have been in the countless millions who participated in body and spirit in its realization. So, if we're going to summarize all about this, many changes already happened in Philippine literature under different countries who colonize our country. And of course, a certain changes once the other Filipino leaders governs and manage our country. So as time goes by, it's still currently changing. From time to time, we have to be prepared on the following changes that might appear or happen to our Philippine literature. So that would be all for our discussion for this topic. And just wait for some of the activities that will be posted on your Facebook group and to the ELMS. Thank you so much for listening.